the High Courts Association, learned president of the Kerala Women Lawyers Association, law officers of the central and the state governments, members of the bar, officers and staff of the registry. We have assembled here to mourn the sad demise of Sri Justice B.N. Patnaik, former judge of this court, who left us for his heavenly abode on 28/6/2020. Justice Patnaik was born on 23/7/1936 at Bermampur in Ganjam district. His father, Dr. R.M. Patnaik, was a physician in Orissa Medical Service. He graduated from Ravenshaw College, Cuttack, in 1955 and completed law from M.S. Law College, Cuttack, in 1957. In March 1958, Justice Patnaik started his profession as a lawyer from Cuttack. In 1961, he joined the Orissa Judicial Service. While in judicial service in 1971, Justice Patnaik obtained his master's degree in law from Utkal University. He functioned as a district judge in Cuttack, Puri, and Balasore. He also functioned as the director of public prosecutions, Orissa. Justice Patnaik's excellent administrative abilities paved way for his appointment as Registrar Administration in the High Court of Orissa. Thereafter, on 30/6/1994, he was elevated as an additional judge of the Orissa High Court. After some time, Justice Patnaik was transferred to Kerala High Court on 26/7/1974 and continued here until his retirement on 22/7/1998. After retirement in the year 1998, Justice Patnaik was appointed as chairman of the Orissa State Administrative Tribunal. Justice Patnaik shared the bench in the Kerala High Court with Justice K.G. Balakrishnan, who later on became the Chief Justice of India, Justice K. Sridharan, and Justice K.K. Usha, who later on became the Chief Justice of this court. Justice Patnaik sat mostly on the civil side. Besides, he also dealt with the subjects, cooperative societies, education, and service. He had rendered several landmark judgments. On this occasion, I wish to recall the words of then learned Advocate General on the retirement of Justice B.N. Patnaik. I quote, "During the time he has been a judge of this court, he has endeared himself to one and all by soft-spoken, amiable manners. Justice Patnaik has been distinctive in the Catholicity of his interests, the clarity of his social vision, and the certainty of his moral purpose. He brought to bear exceptional intellectual and writing skills on the mundane task of writing judgments. His overriding characteristics have been the extraordinary humility, compassion, and generosity of spirit that informed his work and his lifestyle. Justice Patnaik has also been intellectually engaged in researching the problems of victimology and the cause and consequences of crime in society. He believes deeply in the importance of genuine and comprehensive criminal law reforms to provide alleviation to the victims of crime. His interest and work in criminal law and criminology is little known to us, since during the time that he has been with us, he mostly sat in other jurisdictions. He believes that learning is not attained by chance, but it must be sought for with order and attended to with diligence. Today, as Justice Patnaik, the simple serene Samaritan of justice leaves us, we draw comfort in the thought that life's dust brings its lamp with it. I'm sure in the quiet home of his hometown, he will continue to contribute to the cause of the rule of law. End quote. Justice Patnaik is survived by wife Srimati Kanak Patnaik, son and three daughters. Along with the bereaved, we deeply mourn the sad demise of Justice Patnaik. May God give his family strength to bear this loss. May his soul rest in peace.
Honorable Chief Justice, Mr. Justice S. Manikumar, Honorable Judges, President of the Kerala High Court Advocacy, Mr. R. Lakshminarayanan, President of the Senior Advocacy Association, Mr. N. Subramanian, President of the Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, Shrimati S. K. Devi, Senior Standing Counsel for Government of India Taxes, Sri V. K. Ravindranath Menon, Registrar General, and other dignitaries present. Justice B. N. Patnaik is no more. He left for his heavenly abode on 12th noon on 28th of last month at Bhubaneswar in Orissa. That marked the end of a highly accomplished and virtuous life, the exit of an inimitable personality off the face of the earth. Joined the National Service in Orissa in the year 1961, Justice Patnaik was elevated as an additional judge by the High Court of Orissa on 30-6-1994, and within a month or thereof, he was transferred as a judge of the Honorable Court, which position he adorned for more than 4 years with rare restriction and sublime achievements. Possessed of keen and sharp intellect, highly erudite and deeply learned, he was an embodiment of rare virtues, of unique qualities that made him one of the outstanding judges and highly celebrated legal personality of our time. By his affable nature and nobility of his character, he could conquer the hearts and minds of particularly a generation of judges, lawyers and others concerned with the field of law who were fortunate to be his contemporaries. More than 22 long years have passed since his leaving us on laying down the office of judge of this court, but still the memory of that glowing and scintillating personality of Justice Patnaik lies deeply engraved in our minds. Justice Patnaik was a highly erudite and accomplished judge. Several landmark judgments he had rendered, embracing different and diverse fields of law, bear eloquent testimony of his intellectual efflorescence, depth of learning, and unmatched forensic expertise that had gone into the making of a great judge. His versions of law and justice will enrich and revitalize the generation of lawyers to come and provide to them an insight into how law should be interpreted and modulated and to suit the necessities of time. For him, justice was a faith without a dogma. Backed by his profound scholarship in law, he could emerge as a powerful spokesman of social justice. His soul was always in anguish for the downtrodden and marginalized in society. The social inequalities and sufferings of the hapless pained him most. He was a man who ardently believed that in what Gandhiji always carried close to his bosom, that innocence and humility are the cardinal principles gaining a version to the destination of truth and justice. The extraordinary wisdom and virtues of faith he lived for had their emphasis on meting out justice to the tormented soul. The pioneering works of he did in widening the horizons of victimology reflects his unique characteristic of his mind. Love and compassion for the fellow men were the cardinal articles of his faith, and humility and generosity of spirit were the guiding lights of his life. The sad demise of Justice Patnaik is a great loss, not only to the legal field, but the social life of the country as well. It will take long years to fill a void created by him by his departure. On these moments of bereavement, we, the lawyer fraternity of the state, as a whole, pay our respective homage to the departed soul. Justice Patnaik is survived by his wife, Kanak Patnaik, son, Satyendra Patnaik, daughters, Sabita Patnaik, Sinita Patnaik, and Sasmita Patnaik. On this occasion, we also share the grief of those members of the buried family. Thank you.
My Lord, the Honorable the Chief Justice, Sri S. Panikumar, Honorable Judges, Sri C. P. Sudhakara Prasad, the Learned Advocate General, Sri P. Vijay Kumar, Assistant Solicitor General, respected former judges, Sri N. Sugunabharan, President of the Kerala High Court Senior Advocate Association, Srimati S. K. Devi, the President of the Kerala Federation of Women Lawyers, law officers of the Union and the State, respected senior advocates, lawyer friends, registrars of this Honorable Court, Advocate Clerk, staff of this Honorable Court, ladies and gentlemen watching these proceedings. Today we have assembled here to condole the sad demise of late Justice Vinoy Narayan Patnaik. Justice B.N. Patnaik was a judge of this Honorable Court for 4 years, from July 94 to July 1998. His Lordship was elevated as a judge of the Odisha High Court, where he was serving as the Registrar Administration of that court. When His Lordship was transferred to this Honorable Court, His Lordship brought with him the fragrance of the rich tradition heritage of the Odisha and the breeze and calmness of the sacred Bindu Sagar Lake. I fondly remember His Lordship as a soft and gentle judge who was erudite and bar friendly. Justice B.N. Patnaik, as the then Chief Justice, Justice Om Prakash described him during his farewell speech, had full of qualities of a hermit. His courtroom used to be so peaceful and at the same time enlightening and educating. Sthita Pratnya is one whose mind is not shaken by adversity, who does not hanker after happiness, who has become free from blind attachment, fear and anger. All these qualities of Sthita Pratnya was found in abundance in His Lordship. His dedication to the duties attached to the constitutional post he held was unparalleled. Bhagavad Gita proclaimed that the soul is immortal, it does not perish. I recall what the then Advocate General, late Sri M.K. Damodaran said while concluding his speech during the farewell of Justice Patnaik. I quote, "Wherever you are, you will always be in our hearts," unquote. It was a true tribute from the bar to the retiring judge. On behalf of the members of the bar, I join the members of the bereaved family in their loss. May His Lordship's soul rest in peace. Thank you.
As a mark of respect to the departed soul, we shall now stand in silence for 2 minutes. The registry shall convey the condolence message of the bar and the bench to the members of the bereaved family. The judicial work of the High Court shall stand suspended till 11 a.m. today.